Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be talking about the Salesforce interview process. So I've gone through the Salesforce interview process many times, both as a admin on the hiring end and as a hiring manager. So let's go ahead and jump into it. All right, the first step in the interview process is to get connected with recruiters. So recruiters are a necessary part, I believe, of getting a job in the Salesforce ecosystem. The best way to get connected with recruiters is through LinkedIn. You're going to want to post about your certifications, post all of your wins, a new trailhead status. Then you'd want to post these on LinkedIn, connect with people in the Salesforce ecosystem, and you'll be led to the people who are hiring for jobs and who are ready to work with you. Another way to get connected with recruiters is through Salesforce events. These are like Salesforce groups, Salesforce Saturday groups, other user groups, and through Salesforce events like I've gone to Snow Forest. That's a great one. Or Cactus Force or Dreamforce is a large one. Another way on LinkedIn to connect with recruiters is by thanking people who have really helped on your journey. I'll leave my LinkedIn down below, and I'd love to connect with you. But LinkedIn is a fantastic way to connect with those people. And make sure that your LinkedIn settings show that you are open to recruiters and what type of jobs you're open for. So now that you've connected with a recruiter, the next step is chatting with the recruiter about specific positions. When chatting with recruiters, you should be very open and clear about your expectations for the next job that you're looking for. This could be salary-wise, this could be what specific type of job that you want, what type of org you're looking to work in, and all of these are very, very important. If you don't set expectations here, then you'll be disappointed with the jobs they'll bring back to you. One thing to note here, it's really important if you have a specific skill set that you're wanting to use in your next position. Let's say you are really good at CPQ and you really, really enjoy working with CPQ products, then let the recruiter know that that's what you're looking for. All right, so next, after you're done talking with the recruiter and you're moving on to the hiring manager or to another step in the interview process, there are two different types of fits that you're going to look for within an organization. You're going to look for culture fit and you're going to look for a system fit. So when you're going in for a culture fit interview, the best things to do are one, be confident about your skills and about your experience. This will go a really long way and it'll help you move on the interview process. Another thing that will go a really long way is being very, very positive in your interview and when talking about your experience, when talking about this next job that you're going to be going for, or for their position or about their company. All right, the next one is a system fit. So system fit is just as important as a culture fit. Does this system line up with what your future goals are within the Salesforce ecosystem? And does this system fit align with what your experience has really brought you to as the next step in your position, as the next step in your Salesforce career? And what I've learned is the system, depending on how large or small the system is, it will highly differ what your job on the day-to-day is. So if you are in a small system, what I've seen in experience is that these jobs, you are over all of their revenue operations systems. So this could be Salesforce, this could be possibly the G Suite, this could be Teams if they use Teams, this could be Zoom Info, this could be host of different integrations that you could be working with. So keep that in mind when you are looking at a smaller system. If you are on a larger system, it'll be very, very niche at what you're doing. You could be a business analyst, so you're taking users' issues and you're getting it ready for admins or devs. You could also be testing out what these devs are using, what they're building. You could also be a technical support person where you are taking these user errors, user issues, with records or with the system, and you are turning it into solutions, and it's more of a customer-facing position. And a third one that I like to talk about are the consultant positions when you are doing a system fit. This could be ranging from huge orgs of many thousands of people and of users down to a very small org where they have maybe one, two, or three users, and they just want it set up for their company and ready to go. So keep that in mind if you're going for a large system, a small system, or if you're going for a consultant position. Understand what kind of system you're looking at, how many users, and see if it's a good fit for you. Now moving on to questions that you might be asked in an interview. So this will depend highly on what kind of system you're working on, if it's a large system, or if it's a small system, or if it's a consultant position. But one thing that I have noticed over all my years of interviews and interviewing is that they will ask you questions specific to their org and the issues that they're currently facing. So if you are a solo admin, you will likely get questions about how do I change a page layout? How do I change a lightning page? How do I set up this report? Record types, that kind of deal. How would you integrate this specific tool that we want to use, like Outreach, into Salesforce? If you are on a larger system, what I've noticed is that interviews will be geared towards the automations that they have within their system. So you'll be given a series of maybe flows or process builder and flow, or maybe you're asked to digest a bunch of Apex code and tell them how it works, how it's going to affect the user, is it going to create any errors, that type of deal. All right, and if you are consultant facing, if you are customer facing consultant, you'll be asked likely scenarios about how you would handle a scenario with a client. You'll be asked, this client wants this specific outcome. How would you go ahead and build and test out and release this to their user base? So one thing to consider when you are being asked these questions and in your answers is to be confident and be positive about it. And that'll go a really long way. All right, and now to the part that I think is the most important are the questions that you should be asking about the position. And really take this time to set expectations for yourself between you and your future employer, and you'll be able to decipher a lot about the position by asking specific questions. One of these main questions is, what are the responsibilities of this role? What is the workflow with the team like? Will you be taking requirements from the users and then you build it out yourself and then you test it and deploy it yourself, or is there a handoff that's specifically laid out by the team already? Really important to understand and set expectations around turnaround times between the gathering, testing, and deploying process. If you are expected to turn around an amount of tickets, or if you set expectations on the go. Another super important question to ask is, what's the backlog like? Are you coming into an org that has 2 years worth of tickets that you need to work on that need to be built out? Because that's going to be a lot of work and a lot of catch up. Really important to understand what their edition of Salesforce is. If they are on Performance Edition, or if they are on Professional Edition, then you might not have all the tools that you want to be able to use to automate. And I've definitely walked into a position where they didn't know what edition they were on, and so we had to upgrade. Another super important question to ask is, what are their future plans for their org? Are they wanting to really expand it, or are they looking to keep it very niche and very small and how it is at the moment? And lastly, you should ask if there's room for growth in this position. If there's not room for growth in this position, then you can be able to set an expectation for yourself saying, okay, I only want to be in this position for as long as it is helping me grow as an admin or as a developer on the Salesforce ecosystem. And once that's done, then I want to head on to my next position. But if there is room for growth, understand if that's something that you want for your career. And oftentimes the interviewer, if they are the hiring manager, they'll know how much growth there is for your position. All right, and the next thing we're gonna talk about is what you should know before you sign the offer. And then a lot of these things you will have already talked about with the recruiter, and so these expectations have already been met. You should know things like salary. Does this meet my expectations for salary? Are there any bonuses that will be given out based upon performance? Is there a company-wide increase with inflation? Next thing you should know is starting date. Am I starting in 2 weeks from now, or am I starting today? Also, with the illness going around, you should know if you are working remote or if you are working in the office. Also, how you're gonna get to the office, as well if there are parking options there, if you are commuting in from out of town, is there public transportation? And finally, not as important, but somewhat important, are your stock options. Understanding if you can get the company stock at a discount, and if there is a period of time where you have to work at the company to get those options paid out. All right, thank you for joining me. Be sure to like and subscribe and comment down below if you have any questions about the interview process or anything that you would like me to cover in the Salesforce ecosystem. And I'll catch you guys in the next one.